Hi, I'm Abby Walters with Sager Real Estate in Stroudsburg, Virginia, and I'm going to make a little informational video for you today on this process of selling a house. So if you are thinking of selling, this is going to be a long informational video detailing the process from start to finish. It's a lot more complicated than most people think. So I just want to outline everything to help set expectations. Hopefully, maybe you're watching this, you're getting ready to list your home with me. And I've asked you to take a peek at this video to outline the process, and hopefully it helps answer some questions before we get started. So a lot of you are looking to list your home and sell it and make a profit so that you can take that profit and move into another property. So it helps to know that during this process, you are going to not only be making money, but you're going to need to be spending money as well. So yes, I'm here to help you get fair market value for your property, market your property, and walk you through the process. But what that entails from the very beginning is me coming to take a look at your home and offering you suggestions and ideas to sell that home quickly and for a good value. A lot of things that need to be done before we even get the home on the market are the general things are painting to a neutral color, power washing the outside of your home, having the carpets professionally cleaned, having your HVAC serviced. If you can come up with a list for me of any major improvements you've done, such as you're replacing your roof or your HVAC, that's going to be very helpful for me, not only with pricing, but in marketing and advertising your property. So it sometimes takes a while to get these things completed. So I think that if you are interested in listing your home, for example, in the spring, you really want to have me out in the winter time so that I can take a look and assess your home and give you some ideas and suggestions for getting that property market ready. So once we have your house ready to get on the market, I will be working on a listing agreement and paperwork, and I'll be contacting the photographer. So the listing agreement paperwork, that entails the commission that you'll be paying to Sager Real Estate. And also I have paperwork with suggestions of things to do to get your home ready for photos. Normally we can get the photographer out within 2 to 3 days from requesting them. And I will come out to your home and I'll measure all of the rooms, and the photographer will take the photos, and it's about a 24-hour turn time with when they return those photos to us. So we will have your home generally in the multiple listing system and ready for showings within 1 week of you saying you're ready to take photos and get this house marketed. So the next step is entering the house into the multiple listing system. I may have a lot of questions for you. That's because the multiple listing system is very detailed and it requires a lot of information to be inputted. So this is very important, sellers. When I have your listing in the MLS and I email it to you and I say, please review carefully and let me know of any changes, then please look that over. Look at all of the information I have in there. Look at all the photos. Make sure they're in the order you like. Let me know if there's any you want to remove. I normally get a message back in 1 minute. Looks good. Thanks, Abby. And I know like you have not thoroughly looked that over, and nobody's perfect. I can make mistakes. So I really need that multiple listing reviewed by you, the seller, making sure all that information is correct. There's information on there. If you have a 4-bedroom home and a 3-bedroom septic, that needs to be noted. We have a little septic section that can say bedrooms greater than septic, or septic, you know, less than bedrooms. So it discloses that. So all of that information is super important. I need to get contact information from, you know, if there's two owners, both owners, I need email addresses, cell phone numbers. We have a wonderful app, Showing Time, which I take full advantage of. It's on the MLS system. You can download the app on your cell phone, and I enter my client's cell phone and email in that. And then when a showing request comes out, that's not only sent to me, but it's sent to both of the owners as well. So if someone, an agent wants to show a property Sunday at 4, we all get the notification and you can confirm or deny or request a different time. So it's very helpful. It's just quick and easy, and everyone should be taking advantage of that showing time that has access to it. So once we get the house on the market, we're going to be marketing and advertising, and that's my job and that's my specialty, to get it out there and market it and have showings. Now, this is super important. I know that you want to get your home sold, but I know it's also super inconvenient when you see those requests coming through 6 p.m., 7 p.m., and you're like, I've been at work all day. I've got to get my kids dinner. I've got to get my kids a bath. Well, just get it in your mind that this is going to have to be life for hopefully just a week or two, until you get an offer and go under contract. And I know that it's disruptive and I know it's inconvenient, but this is selling your house. Most folks are at work. Everybody has different hours. Most are not available Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. So they're gonna be requesting to show your home on Saturday, Sunday, Tuesday night, Thursday night, and just be prepared. That is the likely scenario. So I know that it's disruptive. I know it's inconvenient. You just have to get a mindset that this is how it's going to be. In order to get your home sold, it needs to be shown. So sometimes I have some sellers that do not like to be inconvenienced, and they reject a lot of their showings. And then a couple months later, they say to me, Abby, my home hasn't sold. You know, what are you doing to sell my home for me? And I don't want to have to say, you need to allow the showing request in order to get an offer on your home. It has to be seen. So prepare, know that is going to be happening, and then you will not be as upset when it does happen. So hopefully your home is ready. You've listened to all my suggestions to get that home market ready. We've priced it properly, and hopefully we get an offer quickly so that you do not have to go through many weeks of all of those unpredicted showings. Then the next thing is we receive an offer on your home. So when an offer comes in, I've got 4 kids, folks. I have one peeking out the window at me here. So when an offer comes in, we're going to be reviewing it together. There are 2 contracts in this area, the VR form that we use at our office and the NVAR form that's used in Northern Virginia. And sometimes Northern Virginia agents do represent buyers in this area and bring us that contract. So I'm very familiar with both of those contracts. What I'm gonna do for you is to outline a summary of the main terms, and I'm going to point out the big ticket items to you. Can help do a net proceeds sheet for you, which is showing you after what you've paid, your payoff, commissions, what you're going to net. So this is super important. I try to tell my sellers at our seller consult meeting that most buyers are requesting closing cost. We have trend reports, and I'm not going to name specific numbers because they change monthly, but those trend reports show us original list price versus sold price. So I've never seen that number at a 100%. So what that means is if you list your home at $350,000, you're likely not going to sell your home for $350,000. There are negotiations that have to take place in real estate transactions. They don't have to take place, but what the statistics are showing us is that they do take place. So if you don't want to negotiate, you might be having your house on the market for quite some time. We're also seeing a trend, and this has been several years, of buyers asking sellers to pay their closing cost. This can be a hefty fee. When you see this on contracts, you'll see terms of the buyers requesting the seller to pay 3% or 4% towards their closing cost. What that means, what that number is, the 3 or 4 is the percent of purchase price. So around here with our average price range, that's anywhere from $5,000 to $10,000. So that's a big difference in what you're netting. So what I'm here for is to break down all those numbers for you and to show you what you'd walk away with at the closing table. So we would be reviewing, hopefully, one offer or multiple offers, comparing them. I'm here to help you make the best decision with which offer to accept. Some offers have home inspections, some do not. Some have appraisal contingencies, some do not. Some are asking for home warranties and some do not. I like to recommend that my sellers provide a home warranty straight from the beginning. They're about $600, $650. And if you take one out, take a home warranty policy out in the very beginning of your transaction, then that is in effect immediately. So sometimes something can be found, you know, during the home inspection that the home warranty company may go ahead and take care of. Otherwise, it is helpful to buyers. I had a buyer recently tell me that the ice maker wasn't functioning in her refrigerator. We just closed on her house about a month ago, so she contacted the home warranty company and they set someone out to repair it. So you do have a deductible, but it's like, you know, a regular kind of like an insurance policy. But they are very helpful. If you go ahead and do that at the time of listing, then it's an extra bonus that you can use for marketing. But sometimes even if you don't offer it, buyers do ask for that in your offer. So I just want my sellers to be prepared that they may be offered a lower price than ask price. They may be asked to pay buyer closing cost. They may be asked for a home warranty. Some of these sellers are just, if you're not fully prepared or your agent hasn't fully prepared you with what to expect, you may just be like feeling like, whoa, you're getting hit with commission. I'm hit with home warranty. I'm hit with buyer closing costs. Why doesn't buyers pay their own closing costs? Why do I have theirs and mine? It just may feel like one thing on top of the other. I want to point out during the contracts that during the offers in that if there's a home inspection contingency, there's even more negotiating to do. So this isn't just an inspection for the buyer to go in the home, have a look at it, see whether they want to proceed or not. They have a thorough inspection lasting 2, sometimes 3 hours or more, and they almost always request repairs from the seller. So if the seller's not prepared for this, then they're even more shocked when the home inspection is complete and they are now being asked to repair things. I just want my sellers to be fully prepared, and that's why I'm asking you to watch this very lengthy, long-winded video, just so that you're properly prepared and your expectations are set so that nothing is a surprise. So during those home inspections, there can be radon tests. I've been having many radon tests in this area fail. After that happens, it's the seller's responsibility to install a radon mitigation system, which can be anywhere from $800 to $1,500. So that's another expense. When you're out here in the country, like I am, you have well and septic test. So I'm just seeing dollar signs. My sellers are seeing dollar signs. I just want you to be prepared that selling a house costs you money as well as makes you money. So those septic inspections, if the seller's being asked to pump and inspect, then that is $800 to $1,500 out of their pocket just for the pumping and inspection. And then if repairs are needed, that's additional cost. A water test is done. And if water has, there's two forms of bacteria we test for, coliform and E. coli. And if either one of those is present and a UV light is recommended, that's another $800 to $1,000 coming out of your pocket as the seller to provide clear water for the purchaser, which is a condition of the contract. So these are all things that my sellers really need to be prepared for. This is a process. I don't want my sellers to be feel like they're taking advantage of or not treated fairly, because this is why I have a job. This is what I'm here for. It's a process. There's a lot of details to it. If you are not aware, you can just feel like you're majorly having to put out dough to cover all of these things. So one good thing is generally these real estate transactions are 30 to 45 days. Sometimes they're 60. Most of these contractors that install the UV lights or do the septic repairs or do the chimney cleaning, generally they'll provide me an invoice, you know, that says paid in 30 days. So I can pass that along to the attorney and that payment can come out of your seller proceeds. Of course, if for any reason we did not go to closing, you would be responsible for payment of that bill. But this generally helps take a little bit of the sting out of the money that you're having to put out to sell your home. So the very first process after we receive a contract, we need to decide who your representation is going to be, what attorney or title company is going to represent you as your settlement agency. If some people haven't sold a home in a while, they are under the impression that who the buyer has selected in their contract is who you'll be closing with. That is not true. Generally, most sellers and buyers these days have their own representation, and we're actually sitting in different offices at different closing tables on the day of settlement. It's not typical anymore for us to be sitting in an attorney's office with one attorney, the buyers and the sellers, and the buyer's agent and the seller's agent. That's not common anymore. Generally, most have their own representation. So after we selected who we would like to send your contract to, then we will wait for the buyers to select a time for their home inspection. This home inspection is for the buyer, and their agent will be there with them, and their home inspector will be there with them. So this home inspection is typically not a time for you as the seller to be home. But yes, you are going to be inconvenienced again in this process. You are displaced from your home quite a few times, and this is one of them. And typically my inspections will last 2 or 2.5 hours, but lately I have been seeing ones last for 3 hours or longer. So be prepared for that. And we have an addendum, a home inspection addendum, that'll say buyers have, and it'll be a different amount of days. Sometimes it's 3, sometimes it's 5, but it may say buyers will have 3 days to get in touch with us, the sellers, with their requested repairs. They also have to provide us a copy of the home inspection at that time. So this is another part of the process for us to work through. Once those requests are received, we could say yes to all of them, we could say no to all of them, or we could say yes to some and no to others. I'm here to help you if I need to call my contractors to come out and bring you estimates, anything like that. I'm glad to do it. And then we can make an informed decision together of what to counter back to the buyers if we choose to do so. This is all negotiations. Some instances, I'll have sellers be pretty adamant that they just really don't want to do any repairs. Can we just lower the price of the house $2,000 instead of doing any repairs? And sometimes the buyers are okay with that, and that's what we do. And if that's what both parties prefer, everything's in negotiation and we can handle it that way. Once we get through the home inspection, the appraisal is ordered with the buyer's lender. This is something the buyer pays for. Yay, not a seller expense. And that is typically not as long as a home inspection. So the appraisers will come out, and I generally don't see them being there any longer than 30 minutes. The seller, you do not have to leave your home for the appraisal. You may stay there, and the appraisers are generally pretty quick. When they come out to view your house, they're quick. I have a lot of sellers, after the appraisal's done, they'll be texting me the day after, was the appraisal value in yet? 2 or 3 days after, do we have word on the appraisal? Well, we don't, because it takes the appraiser some time. This is about a 30-page report. It's very intensive. They pull comparable sales and it's very detailed. It's completely something that I could never do. I'm not a paperwork person, and it is a lot of paperwork and a lot of details. And I commend any of you out there who are appraisers and you're okay with doing that each and every day, because I could not handle it. But if you're a seller and you're texting me every day asking if the appraisal value's in yet, know that one, I'm going to let you know the second I see it. The second I see the email, I'm going to text or email you. But number two, it takes them sometimes up to a week to get that report into the lender. And then sometimes it goes into the lender and they're not going to let the buyer's agent or the buyer know till they've ran it through their underwriting and cleared it. So that's a process. It can take up to a week, and I will absolutely let you know the second it's in. Now, all we get to know as a seller or a seller's agent is if the appraisal is good. That's it. That's all we hear. Every week of my life, I have a seller upset because they want to see their appraisal. It's not going to happen. The appraisal is the buyer's report. The buyer's lenders ordered it. The buyer's paid for it. It's for the lender so that the lender can see the value is there and be willing to loan money for the home. So I know you want to know what the appraisal says. I want to know what the appraisal says. I want to know how good I'm pricing my houses. I want to know if I'm right or not, but I don't get to see it. I don't get to see it as a seller's agent, and you're not going to get to see it as a seller either. So just be patient. Know that the appraiser's working on it, and I'm going to let you know as soon as possible if we're all good. Back to when we're discussing offers, if we get, you know, an FHA or VA offer, I'm going to let you know that the appraisal process is a little different. And with those appraisals, they can come back subject to conditions. So we could get an email from the lender that says value is good, but peeling paint needs to be scraped and painted over on the outside shed. So they're going to ask us to do another repair. This is fun stuff, selling a home. I didn't say it was easy. There's a lot to it. That's why I have a job, and that's why I'm making this video, so that you can know the ins and outs and all of this. Just don't want there to be any surprises. So once we get through that appraisal process, we are pretty good. So the lender is underwriting the buyer's file. There's a lot going on that we don't see or know. You know, we get emails, updates here and there from the lender. These days, we're getting quite a few updates. Even me as the listing agent, as the seller's agent on the seller's side, the lender will directly email me. Here's where we are in the process and when we have loan commitment and all of that. On your side, on the seller side, your attorney's going to be doing a title search, making sure we have clear title, making sure that there's not any liens filed against you that need to be paid off prior to closing. All of that is very helpful if you tell me that ahead of time, and we don't have to find that, a title search. But sometimes those things do sneak up. The sooner we know them, the better. But we do have to provide clear title as a seller and owner of the property. So all of that's going on behind the scenes at the attorney's office for you. And then what comes next, when we're getting closer, we're nearing our closing date, then I'm going to be reaching out to you and saying, hey, we are closing on October 31st. What's better for you, morning or afternoon? And this is generally between 9 and 4. So you wouldn't think I'd have to say this, but you're going to have to leave work to come to your closing. I'm chuckling because I do have people that are like, I have to work. I can't get off work. If you're selling a house, you're going to have to be able to take off work, because some things we have to get done Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. And this is one of them, signing the closing docs. We're all very familiar with DocuSign and e-signing, and I use it a gazillion times, from signing listing documents to signing offers and contracts, but we cannot use it for signing those closing papers. We have to be in person with a notary at a settlement company, and I need you to let me know whether morning or afternoon's work is best, and I'll get that scheduled. And as a seller, you don't have as much to sign as a buyer. You don't have a big loan packet. So typically, I try to have my sellers allot for 30 minutes. Sometimes it's as quick as 20 or 25 minutes that we're in and out as a seller. You do not have as many documents to sign. So your company, the seller's title company or attorney, is representing you, and the buyer's closing at their settlement company or attorney. But that company is the one which holds all of the funds. So the buyer's loan comes into that company, and therefore your proceeds will be at that purchaser's title company. We're not allowed to say where they must close. So we could be closing on a home in Shenandoah County, and they could choose a title company or attorney in Northern Virginia. So the money could be coming in to pay for the home, but they need to come record in Shenandoah County and then coincidentally release your proceeds. So I try to let my sellers know, and this happens very frequently, that my sellers get upset because they want their proceeds now at the closing table. This is common, and it doesn't happen. You're not gonna get your proceeds at the closing table. You're not gonna get your proceeds the day of closing. Sometimes it happens every once in a blue moon, but I want you to be prepared, especially if it's on a Friday. You're not gonna get your money till the next week, likely Tuesday. So don't count your chickens before they hatch. Don't go spending that money because it's gonna take a couple days, and I know you're upset. You're like, I'm turning over the keys. They're getting my house and I don't have my money. It's not fair. Well, just be prepared. This is how the process works, and it is what it is, and we can't make it go any faster. I can't get your money to you any faster. This is the way it is. So be prepared. You can come to closing with a deposit slip or a voided check. We can provide that to the purchaser settlement agent, and they can wire it straight to you. Easy peasy. You don't have to go pick up a check. You don't have to wait for it to come in the mail. This is the easiest and the fastest way, but you aren't going to get your proceeds on the day of closing. It's just not going to happen. So the lesson of this video is setting expectations so that there is no surprises and you are not disappointed or let down or shocked. So that's what's going to happen at closing. The buyer has a final walkthrough right before closing. They just want to go check and make sure all those repairs you said you would complete have been completed. What makes this easier on all of us is if you have provided me invoices from the contractors that did the work. Most of the addendums say all of this work is to be completed by a licensed contractor. And if you show the proof of the work, which are the invoices, then that saves a lot of hassle of buyers being concerned about whether the work was completed or not and checking it for themselves at closing. So the more documentation, the better. And I am totally full service. You want me to help you with getting estimates, having repairs done, I'll be glad to, because what I've noticed is I've got a lot of contractors that I refer a lot of work to, and they get back to me quicker than even my own, you know, they get back to my sellers. They get back to me quicker. They get the work done, get me the invoices. I get them paid at closing out of the seller proceeds, and it's all very easy. So what I'm seeing is if my sellers want to handle taking care of the repairs themselves, sometimes they're not getting them done by closing. They're not getting their invoices by closing. We don't have proof of the repair being done. I'm here to help. Please let me assist. That's what I'm here for. But we do need to show documentation. So that makes things easy, so we don't have any last minute issues at walkthrough, and that closing can go off smoothly. The buyer does get their keys at settlement when they sign their papers, so their agent will take the key out of the lockbox. I ask my sellers to please leave all their keys and garage door openers in the home. When you call the utilities, you're going to say that, you know, my house is selling on October 31st and the new buyers are purchasing on October 31st and the utilities will be transferred that day. So you're not gonna cancel, it's a transfer. So that's important to say. And I do not recommend my clients call their homeowners insurance company that day. Just wait until everything's been recorded and you've received your proceeds, and then go ahead and call your homeowner's insurance company and cancel that policy. So I've talked for a good 30 minutes here. My name is Abby Walters. I'm at Sager Real Estate in Strasburg, Virginia. I do list a lot of properties, and I've made this video for my clients, for my sellers, or anyone that's not my client that is looking to buy, to sell a home, and they're wanting a detailed overview of the process from start to finish, beginning to end, everything that can go wrong, and in between. It is a very detailed process. It costs money to make money, and there are certain things that need to be done when you sell. So I hope that this video is helpful. I really hope you watched it to the end. And if you have any questions at all, you can call me or text me on my cell phone, 540-335-2582, or you can email me at Abby@sager.com. And I really look forward to speaking with you. I love doing this job, and I love assisting folks buying homes and selling homes. It is my dream job, and I love it every day. And please don't hesitate to reach out to me.